It would seem as if that has all, even happened, because if we are to go by the laws, again, we'll also remind you of what you said earlier on, which most Nigerians are with you, that no Nigerian is against any fight against corruption, but the processes. And if you look at what is happening, and it has to do with what is there in the books, which says, well, warrants are only executed between 6 a.m. in the morning and 6 p.m. And if they say they got a warrant, what warrant would warrant anyone to come on you after midnight?
You see, that is why I continue to use myself as an example, and I mentioned Chamberlain, and he said that I'm mentioning him. You see, I came to this studio. Nobody harassed me because I never committed any offense. And let me tell you, for me, in the course of justice, nothing is too great to be sacrificed. And I want to maintain this. And that was what the leader of the Sokoto Jihad, late Sheikh Osman Danfodio, said. He said a society can live with unbelief, but certainly not with injustice. Any society of injustice is a society that is heading to destruction. Nigeria has been destroyed simply because there is no justice. And for anybody, for God's sake, all the judges, look at the package that has been given to them. Is it in terms of houses, in terms of salaries or wages or anything? Is it a retirement package? This is because every normal human being understands the position of justice, especially judiciary, in every society, not even in democratic societies. Justice is sacrosanct. And for these persons that are suspected, I'm using the word suspected because no court has proven them guilty. And before they are suspected, there must be reasonable ground for them to be suspected. We know what has been happening. To have consistently abused the same process, the same office, the same rules that we are talking about in order to force on us a system that promotes injustice, and then considering how many people have lost their lives to this very particular, because you see, you will always look at corruption from the point of bribery and then asking and then taking of bribe. No, corruption is not that. Corruption is perversion. If you pervert any given opportunity to serve the public, that is corruption. And then if you corrupt the public sphere, you are invariably inviting death. And this is why today, no election in Nigeria is free of violence, because the politicians themselves believe that, look, it's either you rig and then you'll be taken to court, or you'll be rigged out. Because they believe that by the time they get to the court, they can sort themselves out. And that is why perpetually every election, people are dying. Secondly, you have a situation where somebody stole, say, Maggi out of hunger. The person is sentenced to 5 years imprisonment, or 3 years imprisonment, or 2 years imprisonment. Somebody stole 3 billion from public coffers, and the person is fined 300,000, 500,000, 600,000, and the person is allowed to go. And what are you telling me as a younger person? You're only telling me to steal, then if I'm taken to court, fine, I pay 600,000 naira and I walk away. These are the issues. So for them to have even abused the temple of justice, they've even forsaken their right, despite all Nigeria has been doing for them.
That's the other part which I don't understand. I mean, you say, yes, they're suspect because they've not been found guilty. Now, in another breath, you say for them to have abused the rule of law. But I'm still trying to understand your perspective. Are you saying or suggesting that we should do away with the rule of law when we are trying to get results?
There are two things involved here. For those of us that believe in religion, if you want to go to heaven, you have to die first. It's a process. Before you are taken to court, even if you are suspected, you must be arrested. And what has been done is arresting based on sufficient ground for suspicion that somebody somewhere abused his office and that person needed to be prosecuted. And the first thing to do is to arrest. And now, after the arrest, you'll be given the chance to prove whether you are innocent or not. And after the arrest, they were released on bail to show that, okay, the case was going to continue. But a case has been established that, okay, these people were suspecting them of so-so-so and so-so thing, and that, okay, they need to be given fair hearing so that they defend themselves. So arresting somebody is not a guilty verdict that the person is guilty. It is a process. For instance, if you really, if I must talk to Nigerians, it means I have to come to this studio. Then how I got to this place is immaterial as far as Nigerians are concerned. What they want to see is, are you bringing somebody to come and talk to them? So for me, that is a process, and nobody has said, and that is why I use the word that for now they are alleged to have, because no court has proven them guilty. But before you can be taken to court, you must be arrested first, or you must be invited. And then arresting or inviting is at the discretion of those people that are charged with that function, either to arrest or to invite.
Yes, but that is also subject to them complying with the laid down rules and regulations, laid down laws. Did you get what I said? That is also subject to laid down laws, which they have to comply with in executing the arrest.
Yes. So the question is, how has their right been abused so far?
No, your impression, if I understand you properly, is that you're saying, look, we just need to get results. No matter how we carry it out, ultimately, we should go for the results. Whether their right has been violated or not is immaterial, as long as we get the results. And that they cannot hide under the rule of law. That's what I heard you say. Am I correct or not?
Yes. It's consequent upon what I said earlier on. I said we live in a climate where people jump bail, where people disguise as women to run away from the law. And if the DSS feel that to arrest them in the night, or the government feel to arrest them in the night, is the best way to carry out the arrest, for me, all I want to see is somebody being prosecuted for use of a crime. So how they arrest them, as far as I'm concerned, it doesn't really matter to me. But is there any reasonable ground of suspicion that this person was alleged or either alleged to have committed this very particular crime and the person ought to be arrested? If those grounds exist, for me, the timing of the arrest is something that it's really bother me less. What is of interest to me is to see that people are being prosecuted for their crimes, because to pervert simply means you are following on due process to achieve a private gain. So if perversion is that, and it's done in secrecy, have you seen people sharing public money in the open? Have you seen them doing it in the parties or at the airport or any other open place? The corruption is something that is done in the dark, and it's a secret thing. And to undo it needs utmost secrecy, especially in the climate that people are ready to evade justice. In other land and climate, once you commit offense, the offenses are read before you, you know that you commit it, you say you own up, because that is the hallmark of a gentleman. But in Nigeria, we are very few gentlemen.
So what do you say to those who are of the impression that the intention of this is, first of all, to tarnish their image, because many went back and said, look, the last time they say the security agencies went to Akwa Ibom government house and said they saw a huge stash of money, and the public never saw it. They've been here, the public hasn't seen all of this. So people just ask questions saying, look, how are we even sure that processes were adhered to before this was done? Because the impression people now have is they are guilty, as has been said, even without the court pronouncing them guilty.
Well, that is the feelings of most of the people that are peddling such a position. Nobody, for me, nobody has pronounced them guilty. I think even the DSS wanted to equally inform Nigerians, not to keep Nigerians in the dark, by saying this is why we went, and these are some of the things we recovered from them. For me, monitoring processes is what is important. For now, they've been released until such a time they are taken to court, and then they did not get justice from court. I believe Nigerians are good people. They are ever ready to ensure that, okay, nobody is really dealt with unfairly. This I can attest to on behalf of my fellow countrymen. They are good people, but for me, the most important thing for now is to monitor the process. Nobody is saying they are guilty. In my opening remarks, and as we proceed, I use the word suspicion. They are suspected to have committed, because no court has pronounced them guilty. But again, it is also, it shows the level of our education in this country. You find a lot of people parading titles, professors, PhD holders, so, and they are still the most ignorant set of people you can ever think of, because they always, if given opportunity to enlighten the people, they always advertise their ignorance as knowledge. And this is what has been affecting us. And that is why Nigerians are feeling that once you've been arrested by police, it means that you are guilty. Or if you are arrested by DSS, it means you are guilty. No, arrest simply means that you have some explanations to make, and that you're supposed to come and offer such explanation. So it's not a guilty verdict, as far as I know. But common sense is not common, and you don't expect everybody to behave the same. Even the level of our reasonings are not the same. And for me, I won't hold anybody responsible, but the nature of our educational system that treat unreasoning as reasoning.
I think the way you've been putting it, sometimes I don't know where you stand. You come this way and you go the other way. But if you look at this whole thing, where does this leave the EFCC and the police?
All right. You are aware that in the past, even some top military brass, where their houses were raided by the DSS, and they recovered a lot of items before they handed them over to the police. And as far as I know, we've been advocating for synergy, and then that the security agencies must work together so that the professionalism of one will equally be of benefit to the other sister agency organization. What has been done is the mode of arrest. So the government may choose to hand them over to the EFCC or to the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice to to really prosecute them, because it is now.
Just give us a moment, Dr. Hamisu. We need to go on a quick break, Dr.
EFCC
Hamisu.
Ought to have, okay.
Just hang on. We'll be back in a moment. Do join us again.